This problem says, find all abelian groups up to isomorphism. I put that in parentheses. If that phrase were not there, it would be implied. Whenever you say find all groups of a certain type, it's implied that it's up to isomorphism. Of order 1,000. Up to isomorphism means any group of order 1,000, in this case, any abelian group of order 1,000 is going to be isomorphic to one of these ones that I'm going to write down. What you always want to do in this kind of problem is, first of all, come up with the prime factorization of the order of the abelian group. 1,000 is 10 cubed, but 10 is not prime, so we're not done with the prime factorization. 10 is 2 times 5. So our prime factorization is 2 cubed times 5 cubed. Yes, that's 8 times 125. But more importantly, think of it as 2 cubed times 5 cubed. What I would do at this point is I would break the problem down and first think about how many abelian groups there are of order 2 cubed, 8, and how many abelian groups there are of order 5 cubed, and write them all down. And then from those lists, combine them to come up with a list for the abelian groups of order 1,000. So abelian groups of order 8, 8 equals 2 cubed. We did this kind of problem last time. There's Z8. There's the external direct product of Z4 with Z2. And the external direct product of Z2 with itself, having three factors, so to speak. And that's all of them. This is part of the fundamental theorem of finite abelian groups. Any group of order 8, 2 cubed, can be written as an external direct product, in this case, a trivial external direct product of cyclic groups of prime power order. And when you've got distinct prime power orders in separate kinds of external direct products like this, they are not isomorphic to each other, we know from chapter 8, because those subscripts are not relatively prime. And yes, we can emphasize the power of the primes as well. That's helpful to do in general. In this case, it's all 2 to the first powers. For order 125 equals 5 cubed, it's a very similar kind of thing, except the prime changes from 2 to 5. So we got Z125. That's your cyclic option. The external direct product of Z25 with Z5. Z sub 5 squared, external direct product with Z5. And finally, one with all Z5s in it, which are all subscripts of 5 to the first power. Now combine these. For each one over here, combine it with one over there. Since each one of these columns has three groups in it, altogether you're going to have 3 times 3, 9 possibilities for the groups of order 1,000. I'll go ahead and write them down as quick as I can. It is worth doing this because I'm going to emphasize something else too. So for example, we got the external direct product of Z8 and Z125. Z8 and Z25 and Z5, Z8, Z5, Z5, Z5. Now move on to Z4 with Z2. Z4, Z2, Z125, Z4, Z2, Z25, Z5, Z4, Z2, and then a bunch of Z5s, going as quick as I can here. And then three more, starting with 3 Z2s. In each case, hang with me here. I am going to write these in another way as well to emphasize, in part because to say that I can. This is the entire list in what you might call canonical form. right? In the simplest way you can think through the problem solving here. But these are not the only ways of writing these isomorphism classes, these 9 isomorphism classes, because what you could do is once again use the fact from chapter 8 that when these are relatively prime to each other, you can combine them, so to speak. You can merge them. So Z8 external direct product with Z125 is actually cyclic. It's isomorphic to Z1000, which maybe you wrote down right away as your first example as Z1000. But there is a way to write it as an external direct product. Again, 8 and 125 are relatively prime, so I can do that. Here, 5 and 25 are now relatively prime, but 5 and 8 are, and 25 and 8 are. I could, for example, multiply 8 and 25 and get Z100 external direct product with Z5. Or I could multiply 8 and 5 and write this as Z40 external direct product with Z25. Those are two different ways of writing this isomorphism class. They are ways you probably wouldn't think of if you're using my algorithm, so to speak, here, but they do work. With this one, I could combine Z8 with one of the Z5s and write Z40 and then two Z5s. And that's really the only way of doing that because no longer do we have relatively prime subscripts. With this one, don't combine the 4 and the 2, but I could combine the 4 and the 125 or the 2 and the 125. I could write this either as Z500 external direct product with Z2 or as Z250 external direct product with Z4. I won't go do any more. All I'm trying to emphasize is there are alternative ways of writing these things, where the subscripts are not necessarily powers of primes anymore. But our form of the fundamental theorem of finite abelian groups specifies powers of primes as the subscripts. And that is probably the simplest way to think about them all, to make sure you've hit them all.